Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to go over the attributes you will use in your image elements to display them on a web page. So I've got this web page set up, and if I were to refresh it, you can see that there's no image on there, so let's get one in. And I've already got a page set up, nothing too fancy on it, just a headline and some generic text, and I'm using the figure element in order to contain my image. Let me zoom in here a bit for you. So you've seen in a couple of other videos of obviously if we want to create an image, we're going to use the image tag, IMG. And the image tag is a self-closing tag, meaning it's a singleton tag or there's no separate closing image. So no need to put in IMG. And if you ever see that, that is incorrect. Okay, not necessary, unessential. Still works, but it's a bad habit, so why do it? In the image tag, there's a number of attributes we can use, and there's a few that you definitely need to use. So first and foremost, the very important source attribute. The source attribute tells the browser where the image is located that you want to display. So the image I want to use is in my images folder, and there is a photos subfolder in there, and I want to use lawson1.jpg. So that's the picture I want to use. So I will save in my editor, jump back over to my browser and refresh, and now my image displays exactly where I want. Now the image is displaying over here because I've already got some CSS where I'm floating my figure to the right. And when you float an element to the right, the text or content that follows it will wrap around the left. You float to the right, what follows wraps around to the left. If you float to the left, which follows wraps around to the right. You can float left or right. So that's the basic source. Now the other attribute I'd like you to use all the time is the alt attribute. The alt attribute provides alternate text for your image. It's used in some search engine optimization, but it's designed specifically in order to provide a text alternative for those that might have a vision impairment, so extremely useful. So the alt attribute, and for this I'm simply going to put in simple text that describes the purpose of this image. And of course this is an image I took, so I'll just write in, it's Bumpass Hill in Lawson National Park. Okay, so I've got my text enclosed in quotes here. Of course, you can use spaces and uppercase as you wish inside of your alternate text. Now, that doesn't provide a direct benefit to the sighted visitor of your web page. On some browsers, when you mouse over, it'll provide a text pop-up, but not here. Now, something else I'd like you to consider using. Source and alt, let's call those the required attributes. Now, something else you might use is some sizing attributes, specifically width and height. And you can do this with some CSS, but I want to do it here with the HTML. So in the HTML for my image, I will simply type out width equals 400, height equals 300. And save this, head back over to my browser, refresh, and it just got scaled down. I think the original image was around 500 or 540 by 480 or something like that. So now we can see that image got sized down. Now you might be thinking, well, gee, what's the real value of doing something like this, width 400, height 300? Because the image, especially if you went into an image editor prior to this and you sized your image to what you wanted, you're like, what's the real value of this? Well, the value of sizing your image using either CSS or the width and height HTML attributes is that your web page will allocate space for this image while it loads everything else. Now, I can't really demonstrate you the problem of this one here because, you know, this image loads so instantaneously fast that you really don't see the value of it. But check this out. What if my image was broken, okay? It just didn't work at all. Well, because I have the width and the height set, space is still allocated for that broken image, and my other page content, in this case my text, has a perfectly normal layout. There we go. Now if I didn't have the width and the height set for this image and my image was broken, there we go. It does affect the layout on the rest of the page. So by having your layout, or I'm sorry, your sizing attributes for your image right in there, it allows the web page to load the text first, in exactly the space that it needs to be, and then it can jump over and put in the proper image so that that works. And for web pages where you might have lots of images, or the images might be a little slower in downloading, it's kind of nice. Imagine someone's on their mobile device. Even a relatively small image might be a little slower to download than normal. So you could have the user can start reading text content while the image is loading. So get those sizing attributes in there.